This episode is brought to you by Squarespace.
Welcome to Techzilla Bytes, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Shannon Morse. For several years now, us Linux users have had to do several workarounds just to get Netflix to work on our machines. We had to use software libraries like Wine to get the Windows version of the Silverlight plugin running. Developers have made it easy to use the Wine libraries by developing plugins like Pipelight, which can play Silverlight, Flash, Shockwave, and the Unity web player all in your Linux browser. But emulate no more. Now you can get Netflix up and running natively. Now, to get this up and running, first you need to install the Google Chrome dev or beta versions. I downloaded the beta onto my Ubuntu Live CD, which is right here. You can find that over at google.com/chrome/browser. This is the beta version that I downloaded again. You'll also need to upgrade your libnss3 files to the newest versions. We'll have that full link in the show notes for you. Download the zip file found at this really long link, and then click the little download button up at the top. It appears right up there. And you want to open this in the archive manager and copy the three deb files over to your home folder. This is exactly what they look like. You want to make sure that you copy those right over to your home folder. Just click on the little home button at the top to make sure that you're open over there. The next thing you'll need to do is go over to your terminal. It looks a little scary, but work with me. It's very easy. All you need to type in is sudo dpkg tacki libnss3 star. That's going to pull up all three of those different directories, and it'll install each one for you. Super, super simple. Now you want to add the Chrome Web Store plugin called User Agent Switcher Extension. Just click Available on Chrome, or just click Install if you're working in Chrome already. Once you have everything installed, you can right-click on this new little icon that appears. It looks kind of like a little mask, and you want to go over to Options. When you open up options, you'll get a nice little custom user agent list. There are just a few options that you need to change. First off, under name, you want to type in Netflix, Linux. Under new user agent string, and we'll put this in the show notes as well, you want to copy over this entire string and put it under there. Group should be automatically filled in. Append should be replaced. And lastly, under indicator flag, you want to type in IE. Now click add, and it should automatically add to your Chrome extension list. After you click add, you want to go ahead and restart Chrome. Now you can reopen Chrome and go to netflix.com and go ahead and log in. Now you want to click on that icon again and choose Chrome, Netflix, Linux. It'll look like this. Click on Chrome and Netflix Linux. Netflix.com should restart for you. It should refresh, and you should be able to start watching movies. So let's see if this actually works. I'm watching Doctor Who right now, and it totally works, and it looks beautiful on this, even though it's running from a USB. Now, everything should work beautifully. If not, restart your computer completely and make sure that you downloaded the exact versions that I'm using for each and every step. Credit to omgubuntu.co.uk for providing most of these steps, and I hope that this helps you get Netflix finally on your Linux computer. I know it helped me, and I'm super excited. Now, get creative with a new website. You can create your new website in minutes on Squarespace. Squarespace has the all-in-one platform to make it easy and fast to create your own professional website, portfolio, or online store. They offer beautiful designs, drag-and-drop content, and 24/7 support. Plans start at $8 a month, and they include a free domain if you sign up for a year. For a free trial and 10% off, visit squarespace.com and enter offer code Techzilla at checkout. A better web starts with your website. For more from Techzilla, hit up youtube.com/techzilla or techzilla.com, and check out our Techzilla Byte about turning off iMessage when switching to Android. I'm Shannon Morse. Thanks for watching.